reform bills is passed, what is your party going to do for the city of Mumbai in terms of increasing and training the number of police personnel and in terms of passing and implementing the police reform bills which are crucial to ensuring that the police work in a productive and unbiased manner? Meanwhile, will your party also ensure that political interference in police appointments and transfers is done away with completely?
My party is against political interference in police completely. You can take it from me.
All right.
We are against political interference in every aspect.
Okay, that's a very good one-line answer. We want the same one-line answer from everybody.
I think a lot has already started happening where police reforms is concerned. And when you see even of interference on the transfer of police, yes. Police reforms is number one on our agenda. If you read our manifesto, that is part of police reforms. We have a new CP who is assigned, Mr. Rakesh Maria, as you all know him. And he comes with a vision for Mumbai. He comes with a vision for transforming what the police is actually supposed to do, that is maintain law and order rather than get involved in civic issues. And where transfers and interference of politicians and appointments of police personnel are concerned, that too is happening. And excuse me. What is the job of a police officer? The job of a police officer is to maintain law and order and curb crime. That is the job of the police officer. They should know that's what they are.
Let's move on, please. Yes, Farhan.
Mumbai police is really working for the ruling government. And I will tell you proof of that. Ma'am, give me 30 seconds. There is an FIR lodged against the local MLA. I would like him to please arrest Mr. Baba Siddiqui.
Staff, the police and the judiciary. This has resulted in a number of rape survivors choosing not to register a complaint and to keep silent. How does your party propose to implement a single point cell comprising legal medical and police services for women survivors of rape that will treat them with compassion and dignity? The additional question is, Juveniles are perpetrating heinous rapes with alarming regularity. What does your party propose to do legislation-wise to remedy this? How do they get away just because they are labeled juveniles?
In fact, my question is, if the boy has committed the act of a man, then he should get the punishment of a man.
I want to say that our government has passed the bill. We've also amended the CRPC. We've also ensured that the two-finger test which used to happen does not happen. There is, when a woman comes into a police station or goes to a medical officer, there is a psychologist there. There is a person, a female doctor there who checks up.
Ma'am, so does this actually happen?
No, it does. That is the reason. No, I really disagree because the amount today, people are coming out, there is an awareness that when, even if there is a molestation, even if there is voyeurism has been put into this act, when you see the Shakti Mill conviction which has happened so swiftly, that is a deterrent, because we are looking at convictions. When you see convictions happening, there is more faith in law. People will come and address the issues, people will lodge FIRs, people will put in complaints. Therefore, the Shakti Mill judgment has been something which I think we should really look at as a landmark judgment. When you talk about juvenile justice, this is a matter, even I agree very much with Shama. If a boy commits an act of a man, he should be punished like a man, especially in the brutal acts which has happened. You know, in the Nirbhaya case or the cases of Shakti Mill, where there is brutality involved.
Yeah.
But this is a matter of debate as well.
Okay.
There are a lot of NGOs and a lot of organizations who are against this death penalty. Okay, Priya, can yes, last one.
Shama, before we move ahead, the question specifically was about a one point cell. We
yeah.
have to move around.
Single
to
point cell.
Places.
So that has happened. That has happened. Priya, 1 minute, 1 minute. Those of us who saw the Satyameva Jayate program, if you remember, there are two doctors there who very clearly said that if you don't form a three-point cell where medical, legal and police help comes under one, the rape survivor, I refuse to call her a victim, the rape survivor has to run to three different places. So have one cell for all three. Do you agree with this or not?
Next, Puna.
With due respect for all the members sitting here, it has happened in Gujarat. We have separate police cells, police stations for women. If you're molested, attempt to rape, everything is under one roof. And that implementation has happened in NDA states, and which I am stating, you can recheck also. I mean, it's a democracy, and do check.
I just have forgotten, and I just want to say, if this man standing here is questioning my integrity in any way, I'm not going to be standing here.
Exactly. And he will stand up in front of the TV camera.
I don't think he is educated enough to understand when you have land, it appreciates. It does not depreciate. Okay?
So, okay, so that I answer your question. And you are 1 minute, sir, you might be on the TV channels. You cannot just put up any question, anything like this. Please throw him out.
Throw him out!
Yeah.
I just want to make one point. I think, you know, no amount of women's security talk will actually be practically implemented unless we make sure that online filing of FIRs as per Justice Verma Committee's recommendations are implemented, so that the woman does not even have to come to the police station and go through the humiliation. So the start has to be online filing of FIRs, which is very, very important. And I think rape is not about sexual assault on a woman. Rape is about a man wanting to subjugate a woman.